Hello, and welcome to dbForge Studio for MySQL tutorial. In this video, we will learn how to use dbForge Studio to view and manage the processes running in a MySQL server. MySQL or its compatible database engines come with a useful command called showProcessList. A user with the process privilege or higher can run this command to see every running thread in the instance. These processes can be system processes like database engine threads or user processes like queries running in a database. It's useful to run showProcessList when you suspect a bottleneck in the server due to large number of connections, or if you want to see who's running what in your database server. Sometimes client applications can disconnect, leaving orphan processes running in the server. Running showProcessList will help you identify those orphan processes. In our example, we are running an Amazon RDS MySQL instance. We are logged into it as the user administrator. This is the master user for this RDS instance. Let's run the show full process list command from the admin user's query window. As we can see, there are few sessions running in this MySQL instance. The query result set has a number of columns. Let's go through the important ones. The ID field shows a unique identifier for the connection. This is the process ID. Every MySQL process can be identified by its unique process ID. The user field shows the identity of the user running the process. We can see there are few connections from user 1, user 2, user 3, and so on. Sometimes there can be users listed as system users. These users represent database internal threads. The host field shows the client machine's address. For system processes, the host field will be blank. We can see most user connections are coming from one IP address. User 1, on the other hand, is connected from two locations. The time field shows the number of seconds the process has been in the current state. The info field shows the command run by the process. If the field is null, it means the connection is idle. We can get the same information from the process list table in the information schema database. Let's run a query on that table. As you can see, we have the same columns here with the same information. Now, you don't have to run these queries manually. In dbForge Studio for MySQL, you can select the database menu and then choose Session Manager. Once again, you have the process information in the Session Manager screen. Let's switch to a MySQL client machine. Here, our client machine is an Amazon EC2 instance. User 6 is going to connect from here to the RDS instance and run the MySQL Slap utility. During the run, MySQL Slap will emulate 50 concurrent connections, all running under User 6. Each connection will run an auto-generated SQL statement for 10,000 times. We start the process and wait for some time. Now, we switch back to dbForge Studio and refresh the Session Manager screen. We can see the connection from user 6 is using a process ID of 56641. Let's say this is our rogue process. This process is putting so much load on our server that other users can't connect and existing queries are running extremely slow. You have been asked to terminate this process. We switch to the administrator query window and run this command. Kill, followed by the process ID, 56641. We get an error message saying we are not the owner of the process. This is a feature of RDS MySQL. In RDS, only the RDS admin user is the true super user. The master user doesn't have the actual root privilege. The kill command would have worked if we were running MySQL in a non-managed MySQL instance. For Amazon RDS, we need to run something like this. Call mysql.rds_kill, then within parentheses, the process ID. Now it runs successfully. let's go to the Session Manager screen. As you can see, User 6's process is no longer there. If we go to the EC2 console, we can see a message saying the connection to MySQL Server was lost during query. In other words, we have forcibly stopped a MySQL user process. What you just saw here today should be used only as a last resort. When the process you want to kill is causing severe performance problems, and there is no way to gracefully stop it from the client side. Usually, this should not be the case if your applications and queries were designed properly and they don't block other processes for a long time. Also, bear in mind, killing system processes can have potentially damaging effect on the database server, sometimes causing it to crash. Therefore, as a DBA, you should do all your investigations before killing any process. With 160 products, Devart is one of the top database companies in the world today. On average, Devart products are downloaded 37,000 times a month. Nearly 60% of Fortune 100 companies use Devart database tools. To know more about the company and its products, visit the website.